Have you ever wanted to make 3D prints with your SketchUp models? In this course, I show you how you can get your models ready to print so you can see them in the real world. I'm Brandon Gibbs, and I bring 20 plus years of architecture design 3D fabrication to all my courses. If this is something that's new to you, then you can check out my other courses below to get prepared. This course is for those who have a little bit of experience in 3D and SketchUp, so it'll help you get to the next level with 3D printing. If you're ready to get started with 3D printing your models, then let's go. SketchUp is a great 3D modeling program. It's also great for 3D printing. As you see the SketchUp interface in front of you, you will see several tools to the top right that are great for solid modeling. And we'll get into those as we go through how to make a model for 3D printing in SketchUp. Typically for architects and designers, we are looking to show certain types of details in our models. So actually this mass model is very useful, but we do like to show several details as we model. Let's start from the beginning with basic concepts. SketchUp, as you can see from this large toolbar, which we will actually not really need so much, we could do this all with a simple. It's a modeler with lots of lines. Lines that cannot be 3D printed. Doesn't matter how many you make or how 3D they are. Also, planes can't be printed because they have zero thickness. You will need to be using solids. So if I take this mass, it won't be printed as it is, but if I do this, we can print it. We need to understand how scale is being done in SketchUp. And so one important way to do that is through our preferences, where we can choose the scale of the drawing. Pretty much the format of scale, where we can choose architectural, meters, as we are going to be working in scale for a 3D printer, we need to think in centimeters. You can also convert your model so that would be clear. The build plate for our repetier is 30 by 30. And so just to make sure that this is coming out properly, I'm just gonna make a test print. And we'll go up 10 centimeters. And as this is the whole build plate, we will still see, maybe we'll bring it in a little bit, maybe 2 per side. And so we'll measure that. 28 by 28. And then we're going to go through the procedure to get this into Repetier. As you can see, this was this extruded form, but it is a solid mass. And I'm going to right click to make this a group. You can also do this with components. It says that it's a solid group. So mind that. If you copy this, and I'll just show one of the changes people might do, they might add a different part, and then they might actually leave some geometry in the model. When I click on this one, even though this is solid with just a line, it will not be listed as a solid group. So this is something, and there are many different ways it could happen that will destroy your model's chances of being printed properly. Also, there are several ways that we'll go over later on how to make sure you are solid grouping even with more complex models. We'll go ahead and save this and then we'll export it to Repetier. Okay, we save this and now we're going to export it. And in exporting your 3D model from SketchUp, this is only with SketchUp Pro, it's not with the web version. You say you're going to export a 3D model, and then you go down to SDL. That's your stereolithograph model. And I typically make an export folder, and I'm going to label it 28 by 28. And this is for me to know exactly how large my print is going to be. And this is useful, in some sense, as you're working in centimeters, you can actually already scale your model, or you can scale it to this size. But pretty much, it's already exported. The options for exporting, so I just exported the whole model. If you have more than one items, you actually don't have to export them all at once. You can actually, if you select that, go back to export, 3D model, and it's an SDL, go to your options, and you can choose whether you're exporting the current selection, and you can also change the axis, and you can change the units here as well. So that's another way of working with that. All right, so now let's look at, and this, of course, you have to mind that if you're, when you put it in here, that it's a 1-to-1. So if you're trying to do a unique scale like 1/8, you'll have to do a little bit of calculation for that. Okay, we've exported it, and now let's look at it in Repetier. We'll load the model again. And now we see it's a little bit opposite of what we're trying to do. Now, if it's done this way, it's probably actually getting the proper size. So let's do our 0.1. Okay, 0.1 gives us the exact size that we want it. It's this is a 1-to-10 scale. So meaning that our 28 meters is now 28 centimeters. This is a 1-to-100 scale. My apologies. But it's listed as 0.1 here. So again, be minded to have that understanding. How is it going to print based on what you've seen? So you've seen that process and you're ready to export it to scale. Let's model a simple house like we were looking at in Repetier earlier. Now we know how we want to export it. Let's make our form. Let's make sure that we're zoomed in. And let's measure to make sure it's coming out that we want it. Okay, so it's now using centimeters, and we probably wanna go back and work in meters. So we're gonna go back to preferences. And it's useful to always test these things out. 10 by 20, and we'll just test again to make sure it's printing in our preferred method. So we are going to be operating in meters, but we're going to export it, and we might need to change that around as we see that is something that's changing. So preferences helps you choose a template, and of course your settings help you choose. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you learned a lot about 3D printing and SketchUp. Check the description below for the next video in the series. And if you really need some more understanding about SketchUp or 3D printing, there's also links to my courses. I hope you've enjoyed this content. If you have any questions, please leave them below in the comments. And please like and subscribe if you would like more of this content. Thanks for joining me, and I wish you the best in your 3D making.